Everybody said about everything I would like to say right now, and I support the any kind of peaceful gathering is supported by all of us, of course, and whatever we can do to make things correct. If we have any wrongs here, it's welcome. As you say, we've lifted some of this, you might say, in the end of phase one here and trying to get people together. But once again, I'm concerned, and that's why I kept my social distance as much as possible. I wear a mask whenever I go out shopping or whatever, and I try to go, as I'm a senior citizen, of course, during the senior hours at the... So we keep following these rules. I think we'll play into a form of safety, and it's something we're going to have to live with. And I personally, I think there's something with a lifetime commitment here. It's like anything else. This virus has been released, has been sent out there throughout the entire country here. And until we get a vaccine established, or even then, I think we're still going to have to live with this for a lifetime. So we need to do our diligence to safeguard ourselves and our family as much as possible. And the violence, we just cannot condone violence. We have to, there's laws, and I'm afraid our sheriff and our police and our prosecutors will punish those who break this law. So let's make sure that we gather peacefully, do things peacefully, and we're all listening. As a government official, I'd like to hear good criticism. Please give me some solutions to the problems at the same time, and we'll move forward. So with that said, please be careful tomorrow night. And for those who are gathering for Friday night in Leonardtown, same thing. Let's do it safely. I want to put a thank you to our staff and everything we've done. I want to thank Alicia out here, our PIO, for all this communication, things we've gone through here. She's worked hard with our staff and has made it work, and I appreciate that. I will make another comment. Since I'm a social type person, I have missed my blue sheet over the last few months. And for you that don't know that, we usually receive from her a blue sheet on a weekly basis, putting different social things on it and things that are important to our entire community. And I've been hard pressed to see one for almost 3 months now. So that's been part of life that we've been going through here. And personally, I don't like it. But I'm willing to live with it, and until we get a good, safe environment going for all of us, do the safe things, do the distancing, wear your mask. For those of you who are vulnerable, I would say again, stay home. And thank you all very much. And one other thing, I did read that the 2020 census, we are doing a lot better job in St. Mary's County, and I'm proud of you. Does not stop everything in life. These things have to be done. This is leading us into the future. The census are only done every 10 years. If we don't get a good count this year, it's another 10 years before we get a good count. So this is important. You've heard us talk today about grants and funding for various things. This is all part of this census. We get a demographic part of our whole society here in St. Mary's County, and this will tell us what direction to go in, not only sitting here, but for our federal and state agencies to help us. So with that said, get your census done. If you haven't got it done yet, it's very easy to do. Thank you very much.